Hello, my name is Auralia. I'm a personal stylist. My passion in life is to help plus-size women look and feel their absolute best. I believe that we all deserve to look and feel beautiful regardless of size or age. We are going to be talking about those pieces that I think that you need to have in your wardrobe that you highly likely already have in your closet. You just need to shop your closet and or you can shop this video if there's anything here that you feel that you need to supplement your current closet. I've got 8 categories in today's video, so let's go ahead and let's get started. To me, I feel that cashmere is the quintessential fall winter must have because it is so good at temperature regulation. It is incredibly soft and luxurious. It goes with everything. I'm going to be talking primarily about Quince. Not that this video is sponsored by Quince, it is not, but I really think that they offer the best cashmere at the best price. You're gonna find some very luxurious, beautiful cashmere, and that's kind of their tagline is attainable luxury. I do truly believe that that is what they are. The first piece I wanted to touch on is a cashmere scarf. I think that having a cashmere scarf or a cashmere wrap actually is quite a luxury, and it makes for a wonderful gift, by the way, if you're thinking about your gifting list at the moment. It is so soft and cozy, and they have got a bunch of colors in this particular cashmere wrap. Now, I like the wrap as opposed to the scarf more, only because the wrap can serve in a few different ways. You can wear it as a shawl, or you can wrap it around your neck and wear it as, you know, a scarf, or if you're traveling, you can drape it across, you know, yourself and use it as a blanket. I mean, there are a lot of uses for a cashmere wrap. Then we've got cashmere sweaters, and they've got such lovely Mongolian cashmere, and I believe it is washable. However, I steam my cashmere, or I will use like an at-home dry cleaning kit to refresh my cashmere. They have got so many different styles, like this particular crew neck style, and they've got a few colors, and it does come in extended sizing, 1X, 2X, 3X. So there's something there for everyone. Although I will say, if you are my size, I am a plus size 18. Their extra large actually fits in cashmere. I find it to be very comfortable, but if I want a looser fit, then I will go into their extended sizing and get either the 1X or the 2X. So they have a different variety of options available in their crew neck sweaters. Their V-neck sweaters are also really super nice. I think that they are so, so beautiful, so luxurious. Why not indulge yourself for loungewear? What is more indulgent than lounging in cashmere? I have got their zip-up hoodie and their joggers in cashmere, and oh my goodness, it just makes me feel like the top of the world. You know, I feel so luxurious and so indulgent in that. Quince is in the process of expanding their plus size or extended size offerings. Love their joggers. They're so comfy and so luxurious and so beautiful, as well as the hoodie. It is my favorite set of loungewear. If you like wearing a turtleneck, then they have really lovely cashmere turtlenecks. I especially like this one in black. And then of course we've got their sweater dresses. I have a V-neck sweater dress in a gray that I absolutely love. This Quince turtleneck sweater dress is on its way, and I cannot wait to put it on because it is so cozy and so warm, especially for me. I live in the Pacific Northwest, so we get pretty chilly up here. We get very damp, and having that turtleneck is really nice to help keep me cozy and warm. The reason that I put cashmere at the top of the list, I feel that it's important to indulge yourself. And while you may feel that cashmere is out of reach for you, or, you know, it's not something that you would do, I would urge you to reconsider that, because indulging yourself and treating yourself well is very, very important. It's important that you do these little things to help take care of yourself, to help improve your life in any way that you see fit. Which actually brings me to the sponsor of today's video, Skillshare. Skillshare is the largest online community that offers thousands of courses led by industry experts. You can take anything from drawing and filmmaking to illustration to productivity. There's just so much to learn on Skillshare. As for me personally, I have been vlogging a whole lot more. And because of that, I was excited to have this opportunity with Skillshare to improve my editing skills. So I am taking one of their learning paths around Final Cut Pro, which is the editing software that I like to use for my vlogs. In addition to that, I'm going to be taking some courses around storytelling through film, because that's what vlogging is. It is storytelling. It's telling the story of my life and sharing it with you. This is an excellent way for me to hone my editing skills, and I'm so excited to be taking this course because I feel that I know Final Cut Pro, but there are a lot of ins and outs that I don't know that I'm learning through this course. Recently, Skillshare has implemented some new improvements into the courses that they offer, expanding the class offerings to include things like creative careers and creative inspiration and AI and innovation. And when you join Skillshare, you'll be asked to share a little bit about yourself and your interests so that way they can fine-tune recommended classes to you that you might not have seen because they've got so many different class offerings. So they're surfacing these recommendations to you. They also have started learning paths, which I mentioned a moment ago, where it is a sequence of classes that you take in order to improve that particular skill. One of the biggest reasons that I'm excited to talk about Skillshare with you is because as we age, it becomes super important to continue learning. It has been proven that when you continue learning as you age, you maintain brain flexibility and you help maintain brain health. And Skillshare is an excellent opportunity for you to work learning into your life. Learning a new skill like drawing, productivity, filmmaking, design, even cooking, entrepreneurship, all of those things will help to keep your brain healthy. It will help to keep you learning and growing. That way you can maintain a vibrant, healthy lifestyle as you age. And that is why I am so happy that Skillshare has generously offered the first 500 people to click the link that's in my description or on the pinned comment on this video, the top comment on this video. They will give you a 1 month free trial so that you can explore Skillshare, check it out, see what's what, see what kind of courses are out there to learn from. After I'm done with editing and also storytelling, I'm going straight to cooking because you know I love to cook. And so if there's something new that I can learn for cooking, I'm gonna do it. So I hope that you take advantage of this offer to continue learning and continue expanding and growing and discovering. A big thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring this video, and a big thank you to you because you helped to make these opportunities available for me. All right, let's go ahead and let's get back to the video. I think that for the festive season, sequins are going to be really, really big because they're everywhere. In the last couple of years, not so much, but this year, it's everywhere. I'm here for it. I am so here for it. I really love this rose gold sequin dress. I think that it is absolutely beautiful and it comes in plus sizes. So exciting. But then we also have the black dress available. I recently got this black dress from Walmart. The beautiful thing about these two pieces is that they are incredibly affordable. So you don't have to make a huge investment for a really, really beautiful event ready dress. Then we are seeing the reemergence of the sequined pencil skirt, which is very, very exciting. It was a couple of years ago that these were really popular, but I haven't seen them in the last couple of years, and now they're back, especially the ones that have the big round sequins. I think they're called palettes, and it really gives like this fish scale look. So this green skirt that is at Walmart right now is so beautiful and just is giving me serious mermaid vibes. Then we've got this luscious, luscious chocolate brown sequined pencil skirt that is so stunning. I love the fact that they have it in brown. You don't see that very often. So this is a really, really beautiful option. Then we're seeing tank tops as well. in sequins. I've got this green one, the green counterpart to the skirt that I showed you, and I love it because then if you got the green sequin tank top and you got the pencil skirt as well, you have a set. You can really increase the versatility of these pieces because you can wear them together for an event, but then you can break them apart and wear them separately for even more events. This is a really, really great option. I love it. Then we've got this gorgeous champagne, like a sequined knit top that you can find at Banana Republic. It's so, so, so beautiful. Also a really great place to look, and this was actually somebody that reminded me of this on Instagram recently, Eloqui. Eloqui reigns supreme when it comes to their sequined options, especially during party season. They have got sequins of all kinds. You know, they've got dresses with feathers, they've got jumpsuits, they've got everything sequined, and it's plus size. So the option that I have here for you was the one that really stood out to me, and it is this beautiful red sequin dress. You can't find a more perfect dress for a holiday event or a holiday wedding. So, so beautiful. And they've got all kinds of other options as well. By the way, everything that I'm talking about will be linked in the description bar down below, as well as it will be a part of the pinned comment on this video. If you want to shop directly off this video, I'm going to go ahead and have them, as many of these items pop up on the screen. If it doesn't pop up on the screen, then check the description bar down below if there's something that you feel that you want to get for yourself. As far as what's in the description bar, I'm just going to give you the category, and it will have a link to the product set in my Like to Know It shop where all of the different pieces are going to be listed. All right, so let's go ahead and let's keep going. Of course, you knew that I was going to talk about burgundy. I love burgundy. I am so happy that burgundy is having a huge moment. Not that it's ever not in style during the fall season. Burgundy is a fall color. No matter what the trends may say, it will always be around. And it is an absolute favorite of mine. I absolutely love burgundy. And I said it in my color combos video, and I'm going to say it again here. Burgundy is a forever color, and right now that it is so widely available, if you love this color, it is a perfect time to pick up anything or everything in burgundy to supplement your fall and winter wardrobe. I feel that burgundy can carry over into the festive season as well. It is a great alternative to a bright red if that's not your vibe. I think burgundy also says a lot about Christmas or about the holiday season. But you can pick up all kinds of things in burgundy. The first piece that I'm going to talk about are these fantastic, stunning, wonderful pair of very straightforward, very, shall I say it, basic but not basic, pair of Jimmy Choo suede pumps in this luscious, luscious burgundy suede. I think that burgundy suede is like the most luxurious. I even think it's better than brown suede. These beautiful pumps from Jimmy Choo, I think that they are lovely. Yes, they're pricey, but for a shoe that is a fall and winter staple, a definite wonderful investment to make in your wardrobe if you love this shoe. We've got, of course, burgundy cashmere. You cannot go wrong with burgundy cashmere. And I found this particular piece from Quince. It is a crew neck style. They have not yet brought the burgundy into their V-neck style, so you can only find it in crew neck, but still a really stunning piece because that color up against your face is just going to look so, so beautiful. Also from Quince, a burgundy washable silk button-down shirt. Fantastic. You can wear this in so many different ways, and during the festive season, it is a really beautiful and luxurious way of dressing for the season. And you can pair it with their washable silk skirt, the slip skirt that they have. They do have one in the extended sizes in burgundy, and I think that that would make a stunning festive outfit, I think, really, really gorgeous. And then, of course, the burgundy turtleneck cashmere dress that I talked about a little bit earlier. This is an excellent burgundy option. If doing a piece of burgundy clothing is too much for you and you don't want to do a shoe, then a handbag is an excellent option. I have this really unique architectural type bag. It is really, really beautiful. It has such a lovely shape to it. It is a shoulder bag. It is a bit narrow, but I think that you would still be able to fit quite a bit in there. And I've been eyeing this one up for a while now. Then I stumbled across this woven leather burgundy option, and I think that this is a really beautiful option. It is really saturated in color, and then you've got that woven leather, which I'm going to talk about here in a few minutes. And then, of course, my new favorite that has been around forever, and I just never got into it until I found one at a vintage or at an antique store, and it is the Dooney and Burke Zip Zip Satchel in the burgundy with the camel accents. I think that that is a really, really beautiful bag. And then we've got something that is in a super, super, super dark oxblood color, and it is this bag right here. I love this bag. It has got such beautiful structure to it, and I love me a good structured bag, and this is a really, really nice option. This one has landed on my wish list. This is a brand that I'm not familiar with, but that I, in my research for this video, came across a lot of different styles of this particular brand, and I'm like, I think I need to look into it a little bit more. So this bag is really stunning for those of you ladies who prefer something that's a bit more classic, that is a bit more structured, or actually a lot more structured, and it is still at a really good price point. This bag is under $300, and it looks like it could easily be $600-$700 on up. So really great option as far as burgundy bags are concerned. Suede is, of course, something that's been around for a long time, and I know that you probably got something suede in your closet right now that you can pull out to participate in this trend. But of course, I had to put together a little list of things that I feel are really great options for today if you need to supplement in some way. We've got the famous Margot bag from The Row. We've got the original option here. Yes, she's expensive, but if you want to make an investment in a designer bag and one that is in suede, I've mentioned this before and I'm going to say it again. I think that this Margot bag is actually one that is going to become iconic like the Birkin bag. Kind of just has that same vibe about it. So if you want to buy it now, I think it's a good opportunity, because I think that at some point these are going to be very, very valued. You know what I mean? But if you do not want to get the actual original version, there is a really nice designer inspired style on Amazon that I have, and it is faux suede. It's not real suede, but that may not be a bad thing for some of you, because suede does require some care, and so a faux suede might be more your speed. They do have an inspired bag on Amazon that is very similar to the Margot bag, and it's like under $40, which is amazing. Then we've got this option from Quince. This is their shopper bag. It is 100% suede. It's Italian leather, and it is completely sold out right now. So hopefully I can link it. If you want a suede tote, I would join the wait list. I know that I'm going to, because first of all, it is a really reasonable price for what it is. I've got a Quince bag, and they make their bags really, really well. They are 100% leather, and this shopper tote is gorgeous. It is no wonder that it is sold out in all colors, even the navy blue one. Who buys navy blue suede? I don't know. But anyway, even the navy blue one is out of stock right now. So they're all waitlisted, but I would encourage you to get on the wait list if you're interested, because you're not going to find a high quality suede bag at that price anywhere else. So join the wait list like me. Then we've got this other suede bag from Quince. It is a little bit looser, softer in shape, but I really do love the shape of it. I think that it is really, really pretty. And it is also out of stock, so you're gonna have to wait list if you want it, but definitely worth it because it's 100% suede. It's a really beautifully made bag, and it's just really, really pretty. And then, of course, we've got this one from Madewell. And Madewell, I think, is an unsung hero where it comes to their bags. I think that their bags are actually really well made and they're really, really beautiful and they are leather. Not to mention the fact that Madewell is a sister company to J.Crew, which you know how I feel about J.Crew's quality. I really love it. And so if you're looking for a really nice tote bag, I think Madewell is a place to go look. So I have this suede option right here that is really, really gorgeous and would make a really nice gift for yourself or someone else. Woven leather is a really interesting thing. It can be really, really summer, but it can also be really, really fall winter, just depending on the type and style of bag that you select. The first bag that I have for you is this one here. I got this from Amazon and I wore it the other day, like out and about, and I am smitten with this bag. I love it. Now, yes, it is faux leather. It's not real leather. It is actually inspired by the Bottega Veneta version, which I'm showing here. For the purposes of this video, I picked out the one with the chain strap versus the braided leather strap. I think, and I don't know this for sure because I haven't actually gone to go look at the bag, but I'm going to. And I'll report back. But I think that the chain will actually move around easier so you can adjust it from being a handheld bag to being a shoulder bag, you know, having those chains as a shoulder strap. I think that those are gonna move around a little bit easier in the bag than the woven leather strap does because on the bag that I've got from Amazon, it takes a little bit of work to get the strap exactly the way that I want it. I think that it's just because it's leather. If it's a chain, it's a little bit easier to manipulate. And I really like the fact that we've got a little bit more gold hardware on this bag with the chain. I do have my sights set on this Bottega Veneta bag. I think that it is definitely on the wish list. I want to go look at it before I make a final decision as to yes, this is going to sit on my wish list and it'll be something that I'm kind of working toward. I think that this bag is excellent. It is so beautiful. It is very classic. It is relatively new, but I feel that this is a very classic bag. It's going to be around for a long time because woven leather is such a cool thing, I think. And to have this bag with this really beautiful bow and the chain hardware and all of that, I think it's just really, really stunning. Not to mention the fact that the coverings on the holes is also gold, which I like better to it being a matte because I have a feeling that the matte would scratch up too much with the chain. So anyway, we've got these two options. We've got the actual designer version and then of course the Amazon version. Then we've got this Bottega inspired large leather woven bag. It's the only way that I can describe it. It's got a large weave. It is really, really nice. I think that this is a really great inspired bag that is way, way less expensive. Again, we're going to be sitting on Quince here for a little bit because the rest of the woven bags that I have, but one, maybe two, are from Quince. It is again 100% leather. You are getting that designer look for less here, and it is a really excellent option, I think. Then we have their fold-over clutch that they've got in the woven leather, and it is really nice because you're gonna have room for all of the essentials in this, and then you can just carry it around as a clutch. Really beautiful bag. And then we have the smaller woven leather, kind of like a it's almost like a dumpling bag. It has got a long strap on it, but you can wear it as a clutch. I really, really like it. I think the shape and the design is really, really beautiful. And in the brown, it is excellent. It is so pretty. But of course, the brown one is sold out right now. So if you want the brown one, highly urge you to get on the wait list because this is a really excellent price for this particular bag. And then the last bag that I have for you is one from Etsy. And Etsy does a lot of really great woven leather bags. I actually have one that I got this summer that was inspired by the Dragon Diffusion bags. I loved it. I loved it. It was my favorite bag of the summer. I've put it away for the year because it feels more to me like a summery kind of bag. But these that I'm showing you are actually, I feel, a little bit trans-seasonal. You can wear them year-round, and especially if you pick it up in the dark brown. The woven leather, I prefer it in a dark leather. I think that that works best. And by the way, the bags on Etsy are made of leather. Maybe not the highest quality leather. I mean, they're not going to be like Quince that uses Italian leather, but they are made of leather and they're really super nice. And this is a really durable option. print has made a serious comeback this year, but only in its natural state, meaning it has to be in the colors that occur in nature. It can't be like neon or anything weird like that. The two animal prints that I see a lot of and that I think are definite must-haves are leopard and snake. So we're going to cover off on snake first because we don't talk about them very often. You've got this dumpling bag in a snake skin. This bag is so cute. It is such a beautiful clutch. I've got something similar in my closet from Walmart that I've had for about two, three years now. And it's so great. I'm so glad I hung on to it. I was going to get rid of it and I decided not to. And I'm really happy that I didn't. So that's proof that I should probably never let it go. But anyway, we have this one here and it is affordable. It is very affordable. It is under $40. And I think that this is a great way for you to incorporate the snake print trend. I love the idea of a snake print handbag more so than shoes, but I will include, I have a couple of pairs here, but I think the handbag is such a beautiful way of incorporating snake print. It's very subtle. It's not in your face. It's not like wearing a snake print jacket or a snake print pair of pants or something like that. It's just the right touch of this particular animal print. We also have got this really beautiful shoulder bag from J. Crew, and I really like this one too. I think that it is very classy. It is really gorgeous. And I think that it is another way to add the snake print bag in for day to day, because the dumpling bag is feels a little bit more evening to me. This particular bag from J. Crew actually feels like something that you can wear day to day. Then we've got the snake print bag from Brahmin. And it's also a really beautiful bag. I think that this is more of a day to night kind of bag. And so that increases its versatility. It has a lot of really great pockets. It's really, really nice and has a really pretty bit of gold hardware on it. And then we've got snake print shoes. I chose two styles. I chose a pump and a sling back. The pump, because it's got a closed back, it's a little bit easier to wear during the winter if you're in a colder climate. But this is from Clarks, so you can bet it's probably going to be comfortable. I was really surprised that Clarks has such a beautiful shoe because I'm not the biggest fan of Clarks. I think their sandals tend to be a little bit too chunky and clunky, but that's just me. But this pump is gorgeous. I think that it is such a beautiful option, something that's definitely worth looking at. And then we've got this beautiful option from Sam Edelman. It's a sling back kitten heel. I really, really like this shoe. I think that it is very, very beautiful. And I love Sam Edelman. Their shoes are so comfortable and so chic. This is a really great option if you don't want anything that's too tall and you don't mind wearing a sling back. I really feel that these are quite lovely. Then, of course, we've got leopard print, which that one is the one that I am really, really excited for. I love some good leopard print, whether it be in an accessory or an actual article of clothing. Here I've got this handbag. I think it's by INC Concepts at Macy's. And I love the fact that it is a handbag that has got a chain strap with a bit of leather, and then also it's got leather trim around it, and I think that just brings out the best in the animal print. So this is another beautiful option. And then I think that a leopard print satin or silk slip skirt, a really, really beautiful addition. I'm not the biggest fan of leopard print pants. I don't really like the way those look, but a skirt I do like a lot. I think that that's a really beautiful look. And then there's a sweater that I really, really like here. It's a V-neck. It's got a really nice subtle leopard print. This is a great way of bringing leopard print into the colder months, even though this is a lightweight sweater. So you have your flexibility with it, depending on, you know, where you live. You can either layer under it or layer over it, or you can just wear it on its own if you're in a warmer climate. But it's a really, really beautiful sweater, I think, and this is a great way of bringing that leopard print into your wardrobe without doing head to toe. And then, of course, we've got a pair of shoes. We've got a couple, actually. I've got these slingbacks here from Anthropology. I really, really, really love the buckle on this shoe. I have had my eye on this particular style that Anthro has. I saved a couple of them last year too. I'd never have gotten them. And I think I need to really make the investment. They do have a pair of chocolatey brown ones that are gorgeous, but these leopard print ones are also really lovely. I love when leopard print shoes or anything leopard print has got like a black trim on it, because I feel that that black trim really does a lot to bring out the leopard print. I don't know why. I just think that it is a very chic thing to do. And these kitten heel slingbacks are no exception. I love that big buckle. I think that that is such a beautiful, beautiful touch. And then if you're more into flats, there are a pair of leopard print flats from one of my favorite flats makers, and that is Vavaya. I really love Vavaya flats. They are, well, their shoes in general are really outstanding. They are so, so, so good. And these Aria flats, one of my favorite styles, they do have it in a leopard print, which I think is really, really pretty. It's very striking, even though these are essentially knit shoes. They're made from plastic bottles, but they are very, very chic in this leopard print. So that gives you the opportunity to just give your outfit that touch of leopard. It's going to be just very chic and very classic and stylish and just so, so beautiful. Here, I only have a few options for you because I'm kind of picky when it comes to coats, because I feel that a coat is sometimes the first thing or the only thing that people see. So you really have to make sure that it is a really good option. Something that fits your style, something that says a lot about you. And so I've only got a couple. When it comes to a coat, because it is a very necessary thing, coats that are tailored or that just have a little bit more structure to them. I'm not talking about puffers or anything like that. To me, those are a little bit too sporty. I much more prefer a tailored coat because I feel that that is, it's a lot more elevated and definitely a lot more stylish in my opinion. I'm not the biggest fan of a puffer coat. I get it that in some climates puffers are absolutely the only thing that you can wear. I totally understand that. But I think that there are coats out there that I'm going to talk about here that are made for really frigid weather and that will serve as well. So with that said, when it comes to a coat, my guidance to you is to spend as much as you can afford on a coat, because it's a piece that you want to last for many, many, many years, but it also has got a strong purpose. It has to keep you warm. And so investing in a really solid coat is probably one of the best investments that you can make in your wardrobe. And it is an investment because you're not going to get a return on the investment in the sense of money back on it, but you will get utility out of it. It's going to keep you warm. It's going to look stylish. It's going to be beautiful. So, anyway, I'll get off my soapbox where that's concerned. When it comes to a high quality coat that is intended to work in the frigid temperatures, Aritzia is my go-to. Because they're a Canadian company, they understand cold better than any of us. And their coats have got a temperature rating on them. So the coat that I'm talking about primarily is the Stedman, which is this coat right here. I have the Stedman. I got it for myself last year from Aritzia, and I wore it on the coldest of days. I only got to wear it twice because it was in late January when I got these, and by then our temperatures kind of started not being so frigid. But in like the dead of winter for me, I'm gonna turn to my Aritzia coat. I spent probably around, I want to say $300 on that coat, which is probably the most I have ever spent on a coat for myself, and absolute worth the investment because I was so toasty warm. I had my Quince turtleneck cashmere sweater and my Aritzia Stedman coat, and I was just fine. They also have got this other coat here, which is one that I tried on as well. The only reason that I picked the Stedman over this one is because it was the fit. I like the fit of the Stedman a little bit better, but it is a really well-made coat. Aritzia coats are renowned for their craftsmanship. They're very, very nicely made, and they're really good at keeping you warm and looking very stylish, very polished, very pulled together. However, if you're on a budget, I just recently tried a couple of coats from Walmart that I think are really good as well. We've got this coat here. It is by Scoop. It is a faux wool, but it is heavy like a wool coat. It does have that heft like a wool coat, and it does come in other colors. It comes in black and camel and in this really pretty light blue. It is a really good price point, under $70. And so, you can get yourself a really decent coat for that price point if that's all you can afford. But I would urge you that if you can afford more, that you go for something like at Aritzia, because you're definitely going to get the quality and the temperature range and the care and the thought that they put into creating their coats. Then we've got this one from Sofia Vergara, which I absolutely loved. This is more of a fashion coat than it is a utility coat or utilitarian type coat, but I love the fur collar. I think that that is so beautiful. It's such a chic touch, in my opinion. It reminds me of coats that I had when I was a kid that my mom would just love to put me in. I love the fur line coat. I think that it is a beautiful option, especially if you're looking for a coat to wear with dressier pieces, especially during the festive season. This is another option for you if you want more of a fashion coat, although I would urge you to go for utility over style in this case. Maybe do something that's a little bit more meant to really close up here up at the top to help keep you warm. Otherwise, you could wear the cashmere wrap from Quince with this coat and you'll be snug as a bug. But anyway, that's another option that's available to you. The last category that I have is blazers, and I'm only going to talk about this one from Ralph Lauren, because when it comes to blazers for plus size women, I think that Ralph Lauren really is up there in quality. I mean, you can get a beautiful blazer from J.Crew. You can get a really beautiful blazer from Banana Republic as well. But there's just something about the Ralph Lauren blazers that just give off that English countryside vibe, which, if you're about that, if you're a classic traditional, you really want to polish and elevate your look, then this particular blazer from Ralph Lauren is it. I love this blazer. I have my eye on it. It is on my Christmas wish list, because I think I definitely need to have it in my life. It is so beautiful. It tapers in at the waist. It has that extra little pocket here. It's an olive green, but it's got burgundy interwoven. Do not have anything like that in my closet today. So I think that this blazer is amazing, and you can bet that it is going to be really well made. And so this is the only blazer that I have in this category, but I will, in the description bar, have listed a few others from J.Crew and from Banana Republic that I think are really good. And J.Crew Factory and Banana Republic Factory, I think both of those have some really good options too. But this one is a cat's meow in my book, and the one that I highly recommend. All right, I'm going to leave you with my latest video right here. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you very much, Skillshare, for sponsoring today's video. And I will talk with you again in the next one. Bye.